Enterprise Quoting is the multi-channel quoting portal that comes with the purchase of Infor CPQ. Here we can see I am on a homepage, which is the main navigation point of this portal for me, a dealer for a major furniture manufacturer. From the homepages, I can navigate to my new quote bookmark, which takes me to a page full of quotes I am working on, all in this neat card view. I can filter and sort in a variety of ways, including by user, date created, and status. Keep in mind that this platform is entirely role and permission based, so I am only seeing my own quotes and any other information that the manufacturer has set to be viewable by me as a unique external user. I can also alternate my view to a grid view, which displays the information on a line-by-line basis, similar to the look and feel of an Excel spreadsheet. From here, I can continue to filter and can even sort by manufacturer-designated fields, such as a PO number or a quote name. I select the New Quote button and begin to fill in some basic information. As an external user, I have the ability to add my own customers, making it simple to create quotes and orders for repeat customers. This is easy to do by navigating to the customer field over on the left and adding as many customers and individual contacts as I so choose. We can then select from that database. You can see here I have many customers to choose from that I have built up, and I will go ahead and select the customer I'm creating the quote for. From here, you can see that my customer details are now in the quote header, and I can select a specific contact that I would like this quote to go to, as well as a ship to address if that happens to be different than your bill to or corporate address in the quote header. I can enter a PO number if that happens to be relevant. I can name the quote as well, and I can request a ship date from the manufacturer. Now that I have input some basic quote details, it's time for me to add a product, and we will do so by selecting the product catalog. Here you can see I have an array of products to choose from. These can all be sorted in two categories over here on the left, and when I select a product category, you can see it opens up to the ability to filter down and select from additional options such as items that might be configurable as well as parts or non-configurable items, can sort by price range and subcategories as well. In my case, as I mentioned, I am a dealer for a furniture manufacturing company, so we'll navigate to the furniture tab. And then we will select the table that I would like to configure and quote to my customer. We select the configure button. And this opens up our configuration screen. As you can see over here on the left-hand side, I have my first question being asked of me in this configuration. And then the right-hand side is more of a display panel. It's displaying images or options that I select as I go. We'll get more into that as we move along. But to start with, I will go ahead and make a selection, a medium-sized table, the option to select custom if we have a custom build that we'd like to complete, and then we can begin to select our different material colors. This particular table has the 3D visualization capabilities, so it's easy for me as a user to go in, make my selections, and see those changes reflected in real time in this 3D model. We can change the color of the leg material and can zoom in as much as we like to look at all of the pieces and parts of this table and make sure it's exactly what we're looking for. From here, I can navigate to the Detail tab. This is where Configurator lets me know the options that I have selected and the corresponding price associated with each one of those options. Again, being user and permission based, we have the ability to hide or make visible any sort of pricing details that you as the manufacturer would want. Down in the lower right-hand corner, you can see I have a total price for this table. And then finally, I have a summary tab, which gives a summary of all of the options that I have selected throughout the configuration process. I am done with this configuration, so I select finish. And this moves me right back to my quote page. You can see here that the configuration was a success. You see my pricing, and then I can expand these details a little bit. I see a nice image of the table that I created. At this point, I am finished with my quote. We're going to go ahead and take a look at what we want the customer to see by generating this quote document. We'll preview this document. And you can see I have a basic quote document here. I have a cover letter that's specified and addressed to the customer that I selected. If we scroll down, we can see a little bit more detail, our bill to, we can see our ship to address as well. We see who I, as the dealer, what salesperson put this quote together, when it expires. We have specific payment terms that are stored with the Flying M Ranch customer that I selected, as well as their payment method and their shipping policy as well. And then below, we can look at the line details. We can see a basic summary of what it is that we configured and selected for this customer, along with the price. Perhaps upon reviewing this quote with me, my end customer would like to add a second table to their quote. One easy way to do that is simply to go into our action items here on the right. We can copy this line, so it creates a copy of the exact same table configuration. But if the customer would just like to make perhaps a minor change, maybe we change the size of the table to small instead of medium, you can see the rest of my options are still all saved just like the first table, only now we have small size selected and a new price of $2,800 down here on the right-hand side. We can select finish. And we can present a quote that has both of these line items to our customer. Now, if the customer has decided they would like a second version of this quote, one that has only the first office table and one that has both tables, all we need to do is go up to the More tab. We select Create a Version. And then you can see up here now on the right, I am on version 2. I can take off that second table by selecting remove. And then if I toggle back to version 1, you can see both tables are still on this quote version. I can send both of these quotes to my customer. They can decide which they want. And once they let me know what they'd like to move forward with, I simply go down to this convert to order button. It asks me to confirm I'd like to convert to an order, and I select yes. Here I have one more opportunity to review this final quote before you can see the place order button here, which I will select. And at this point, it lets us know that our order has been successfully submitted into the manufacturer's ERP. At this point, the manufacturer is able to review and ensure that everything looks right before that item actually goes into production. This will depend on your unique business process and how you prefer to manage these dealings with your external users.